Queen Victoria.
What really appealed to me was the wit of it, the fun. And also, when I started to do the research, the fact that all this was, like, true. Because we tend to think of the stately, turn-of-the-century, empirical figure. In the early years of her reign, there was all this salacious gossip and intrigue and infighting.
My lords.
Left to her own devices, she'll act rashly. She's 18, she's emotional, she has her hates and her passions.
I think Elizabeth II sounds very well.
When she says, I don't like the way Sir John Conroy is trying to be my private secretary.
That is out of the question.
Melbourne immediately says, well, you must have someone else then.
I've only known you a short while, ma'am, but I'm confident that you will bring great credit to the monarchy. It's true, your education may be lacking in some areas, but you have a natural dignity that cannot be learned.
One of the reasons they immediately get on so well is I think she's not met anyone who takes her at her word.
You don't think I'm too short to be dignified?
To me, ma'am, we're every inch a queen.
No one's just listened to her and given her credence in that way. They became great, great friends.
Thank you.
And there is a mutual respect there.
Lord M.
He was very successful in his way politician. He became prime minister. But he was also a very kind man and very well liked. And he came from a different time that was not Victorian. It was wild and romantic and kind of passionate. People described Melbourne as having ravishing opinions, which is a fantastic expression. It just meant you didn't know where his mind would be on any particular subject. Very vigorous, very lively intellect, and with a great sense of fun. And he was attracted to Lady Caroline Lamb, who was very young and beautiful and willful. She was also deeply disturbed. She would have incredible passions for other people, and she fell head over heels in love with Byron when they were together. And Melbourne, having, you know, obviously been humiliated and deeply hurt and lampooned in the press because it was very public.
The problem with a scandal is that the mud does not always stick to the right people.
Is that all you care about? Avoiding a scandal?
He opens up a little bit about the vicious things they said about him.
I do know how painful and humiliating a scandal can be.
And she says, how did you bear it? And he said, I stopped looking at the papers. You know, and there may be something in that. Stop looking elsewhere for whether you should be happy or not. It's nice to read lines and just think, yeah, I agree with this man.
I thought I would never find any solace. But then I became your prime minister, and I think, I hope, your friend.